The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission has begun an investigation into an alleged multi-billion naira fraud at the Central Bank of Nigeria, which centers on the disbursement of a loan facility being managed by the director in charge of the CBN agricultural loans. Sahara reporters learned that the CBN governor, Godwin Emefiele, presently Jetri, and fighting hard to stop the probe, has reached out to the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice Abubakar Malami San to wade into the EFCC investigation of the CBN Director of Development Finance Department DFD, Yila Yusuf. Sahara reporters gathered that the EFCC operatives last week stormed the CBN department over some atrocities committed by Yila Yusuf. He was accused of owning expensive houses and cars in Abuja and in the Lekki part of Lagos State. Last week, the EFCC went on to CBN DFD, the department that deals with the agric loans and more. That is the cash cow of Emefiele and is led by a corrupt director, Yila. Since last week, Emefiele has been doing all he can through the Attorney General Malami to ensure Bawa does not investigate the department. Changes have also been done in the department by redeployment of staff who Yila and Emefiele assumed were leaking the atrocities in the department. The said director was invited to Lagos, but the matter has been shut down by Emefiele and Malami. Yila Yusuf is accused of owning expensive houses and cars in Abuja and the Lekki part of Lagos, a top source in the CBN told Sahara reporters. The CBN has in the past claimed it attributed billions of nairas as loans under the Agricultural Credit Guarantee Scheme Fund, ACGSF, to farmers. The latest investigation by the EFCC only adds to the growing list of atrocities and scandals that the lavish CBN Governor Emefiele is enmeshed in. Sahara reporters had on September 20th reported that the Arewa Youth Assembly, a socio-economic and socio-political group, called for the resignation or sacking of Emefiele. According to the Northern Group, doing so would save the nation from further economic meltdown. They had insisted that the sum of 500 billion naira, which was stolen in a private Dubai investment towards the end of 2018, should be investigated, as well as other funds that were missing during Emefiele's administration. Sahara reporters had in May 2019 made public a phone conversation of Emefiele, his deputy Edward Lametek Adamu, director for finance Dayo M. Arowo Shegbe, and one of the special advisors to the CBN governor, Emmanuel Ukeje, discussing how to cover up the loss of over 500 billion naira stolen from the CBN in a private investment that collapsed. Two audio files exclusively obtained by Sahara reporters revealed how the governor and top officials of the Apex Bank discussed plots to conceal the loss of huge sums of money in a Dubai investment. The CBN claimed that the audio conversation was genuine, but no money was missing from the bank. Speaking to journalists on Sunday, Mohammed Salihu Danlami and Abdusalami Kazim, speaker and deputy speaker of Arewa Youth Assembly respectively, alongside other groups' leader, had urged the CBN governor to resign over his alleged inability to stabilize the country's bleeding economy. Also on September 23rd, the People's Democratic Party, PDP, asked the CBN governor to resign over allegations of overseen looting of funds in the nation's Apex Bank. According to the PDP, the allegations are based on the affirmations from the Secretary of the National Caretaker Committee of the All Progressive Congress APC, Senator John Akman Udo Dehen, during a Channels TV program. The People's Democratic Party PDP demands the immediate resignation and prosecution of the Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria CBN, Godwin Emefiele, going by the allegations by the All Progressive Congress APC that he superintended over massive looting of funds in the CBN. Our party calls on the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, to immediately invite Emefiele for questioning over allegations by the National Secretary of the illegal APC and National Caretaker Committee, Senator John Akpan Nudo Dehe, that the CBN governor supervised over the pillaging of the nation's vault under his watch, that the party had said. Our party insists that beyond Akpan's allegation, the tenure of Emefiele as CBN governor under the APC administration has witnessed colossal failures of monetary and fiscal policies requiring him to vacate the office and hand himself over for investigation. It is instructive to know that when Emefiele took over as the CBN governor in 2014, Naira exchange for 164 Naira to a dollar. Today, in the hands of Emefiele and the APC, the Naira has tumbled to a near 600 Naira to a dollar, putting the nation's economy on its knees. Painfully, under the leadership of Emefiele, the CBN has failed in its core mandate of managing the economy and took a dive into propaganda with claims that do not reflect the harsh economic reality on the ground. The PDP therefore urges the EFCC not to allow this revelation to be swept under the carpet, as it borders on serious economic sabotage for which sanctions are clearly spelled out under our laws, it had added. On September 16th, a coalition of civil societies backed the Arua Youth Assembly calling for the resignation of Emefiele. Seven different groups joined others who wanted the governor to resign over his alleged inability to stabilize the country's bleeding economy. In a statement made available by the coalition and signed by seven of them, the group noted that the current high poverty rate in the land on the failure of the country's economy under Emefiele's watch as CBN governor. This call became necessary following the extensive review of the tenure of Mr. Godwin as the head of our Apex Bank, which has come to the sad conclusion that he should humbly step aside and allow a more competent person to step in to save our country from total collapse. We understand that it will be difficult for him and his heirs to reason with us, but we wish to beg on them to put on their garment of patriotism and save our country, the coalition said. The statement continued, based on the Arua Youth Assembly earlier call on the governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Mr. Godwin Emefiele, to resign his position as the Apex Bank boss over his inability to stabilize the glaring nose-diving country's economy. We have noticed the sponsored backlash and propaganda against our persons instead of the issues we have raised. The fact that the sponsored messengers of the propaganda couldn't come up with an issue-based argument is a clear indication that Mr. Emefiele has truly failed, and they are only helping in further exposing his flaws because Nigerians are watching. Mr. Governor would have proved us wrong with facts and figures and possibly engaged the services of those with related intellectuals to defend his inability to stabilize our bleeding economy.